click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hey friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about the how the molecular orbitals are being formed, as well as we have also discussed about the bonding molecular orbital as well as antibody molecular orbitals. So now we are going to talk about what are the types of molecular orbitals and how they are being formed. So let us talk about it. So now basically I am going to talk about the types of molecular orbitals. So talking about the first one, that is, molecular orbitals are of three types basically, that is sigma molecular orbital, the second one is pi molecular orbital, and the last one is basically delta. I will write it over here as delta molecular orbital. So each of these molecular orbital, this type of molecular orbitals are being formed with different criteria. And what are those? Let me talk about that one. So let me talk about the sigma first. As we know that the sigma bond is basically formed, we have also discussed in the hybridization concept also. So in this case, we know that the sigma has been formed whenever the two atomic orbitals, or whenever the atomic orbitals, they combine with each other, that is coaxially. So whenever they will combine with each other coaxially, then we could say that maximum overlapping will happen, and that's the reason that the bond would be stronger, and that kind of stronger bond is known as the sigma bond. So it is not only it is depending on the overlapping, it also depends on the symmetry also, and that is what I'm going to talk about. So let me give an example. So this is the example that we have discussed earlier also. Suppose if two atomic orbitals, that is this one, are of the same phase, and because we are talking about the bonding one first, and so suppose if they are combining, so we could see that the electron density is maximum over here, and that is how we could say that the sigma bond is being formed, or sigma molecular orbital is being formed, and that is being denoted by basically sigma. But if they are of opposite phase, or we could say if the atomic orbitals are of opposite phase, and in this case basically what we have did is we have applied addition rule. But so suppose if we have applied the subtraction rule, and in this case basically they will be of opposite phase, and we would find a lobe, or we could find a nodal plane, and from that case we could say even that would be called as that would be antibonding molecular orbital, and that has been represented by sigma star. So this happens, and but we can't say that this kind of antibonding orbital would be that is weak. That is, if I'm talking about that is the two orbitals that they are combining. So if they are forming a stronger overlapping, as well as if they are forming a symmetry, if they have equal energy, then we could say that the bonding orbitals has been formed, and in that case the sigma, it clearly indicates that it will have a lower energy, and that's the reason that more overlapping would happen, and that would be much more stronger molecular orbital, regarding that it would be more stable also. By talking about the sigma star, this is the one which I'm talking about, that is overlapping, and even this is that is coaxial overlapping, but the thing is the rule that is obeyed here, they are of opposite phase, and that's the reason that sigma star is being applied over here, and this also indicates that this is an antibonding molecular orbital. So this is what I have mentioned over here. So talking about the s orbital, as we know that two s orbitals, whenever they will combine with each other, they will form that is a sigma bond, because the overlapping is more, the symmetry is more, and obviously the stability is very high, and that's the reason that they form that is a sigma bond. But talking about the p orbitals, so let me talk about p orbitals also. So p orbitals are being distributed into that is px, py, and pz, that is what we know. So talking about the pz especially, so whenever the pz they combine with each other, so usually it happens is when two pz orbitals they combine with each other, they usually combine with each other, that is with a head-on collision, or we could say like coaxial overlapping. So in this case, even though it has it is related to p orbitals, and p orbitals basically, suppose if I'm talking about in this way, that is, so these are the two lobes that we have. Suppose if the pz is combining with that of the other pz, suppose if I'm mentioning the signs over this, that is plus and minus, and here also plus and minus, suppose, and if they are combining, so in this case basically we could see that The combination will lead to the formation of, that is, only a small, here this indicates that the overlapping has taken place in such a way, that is what we could see, that maximum overlapping has happened, and that is the reason that even this kind of bond is basically, this kind of molecular orbital that has been formed is known as sigma. And similarly, we could also call it for sigma star. Here it would be in the opposite case, while here the bigger lobes, as you can see, this represents the electron density. So here the electron density is more, and all the, if I'm talking about the nuclear axis, so suppose if this is the nucleus and this is the nuclear axis, if I'm talking about, so the axis, or the internuclear axis, it lies, that is, along the nodal plane. So this is what it is. So this is the nodal plane, so it is along with that of the nodal plane. But while talking about the pi orbitals, pi molecular orbital. So the pi molecular orbital is because of, we could observe this thing in the orbitals like px and py. So whenever they will form or they will overlap each other, so this kind of pi orbitals is not formed because of the coaxial overlapping, but it happens because of the lateral overlapping. And this take it, and this can be, that is the, this could create, that is a bonding molecular orbital also, as well as it could create, that is, antibody molecular orbital also. Suppose if I'm talking about the bonding first, so suppose, so this is what I'm talking about, px, and suppose if this is an atomic orbital that I'm talking about, and suppose if it is combining with that of the other px, so this is what I have mentioned over here, and suppose this is the sign that I am mentioning over here, and suppose if they are basically, they are overlapping on each other in such a way that they are laterally overlapping. So therefore, while combination of these two atomic orbitals, we could see that there will be formation of, that is, if they are combining, then we could see that the electron density would be higher in this region, having a positive phase, that is a positive phase, that is why I'm talking about, and one will have basically low phase, that would be negative. So both the electron density are above as well as below the internuclear axis, and that is what we could observe over here, and that's the reason that this kind of molecular orbitals that have been formed are known as pi molecular orbitals. So since if I'm talking about the opposite one, suppose if I'm talking about the antibonding pi molecular orbital, so in this case basically one will be of the opposite phase. So if they both are of opposite phase, then we could see this kind of diagram. Suppose if I'm talking about in this way, suppose if this is, suppose px, and that is combining with that of the other px but of opposite phase, like suppose if this is positive and this is negative, and while this is negative and this is positive, we see they are subtracting each other. So we could say that the minus, that is the subtraction will be applied over here, and resultant would be basically, here is what I want to take. I'm going to talk about. So these are the planes that we would observe over here, where this would be of opposite phase, that is, this is plus, while this one would be the minus one, while this is would be minus, this one would be the plus. And here we could find that there is a difference, and this is divided by the nodal plane. So this is the nodal plane that is dividing this two, that is charge densities or electron density. So this is basically, that is called as pi star. So this is pi star, that is a molecular orbital. And so this is what a short synopsis that I was talking about. And let me talk about the last one, that is the delta molecular orbital. So the previous one, we have got to know that the sigma bond, or that is the sigma molecular orbital as well as the sigma star molecular orbital, it is basically really not only formed because of the s orbital that they combine, but it also forms because of the pz orbitals whenever they combine with each other, that is coaxially. And that is in that, in we have also got to know that the pi, that is the pi molecular orbital, it has been formed where we could see that the internuclear axis is aligned with that of the nodal plane, and that also we have got to know. But talking about the delta one, that is the delta molecule orbital. These are usually formed by the dx2, that is I'm writing over here. So these are formed basically by dx2 minus y2, that is orbitals. And if you talk about the internuclear axis, so the internuclear axis is basically mutually perpendicular to the axis like dx square minus y square. And that's the reason that this kind of delta molecular orbitals are being formed. So this was a short thing that we have talked about. So that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you share this video with your friends. And just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.